Hello students, I'm Ms. Deepika Bhandari. Today I bring you the next learning episode on an important unit of paper questioned document, that is instruments used in document analysis, that is ESDA and VSC. In this episode, we will introduce you to the instruments used in questioned document examination, such as electrostatic detection apparatus, that is ESDA, and visual spectral comparator, that is VSC. We will acquaint ourselves with the principle, instrumentation and working of ESDA along with its applications. We will also study the features, specifications and various applications of VSC. Finally, we will end this episode with a conclusion. This episode comprises of the following modules. Module 1, Introduction to VSC and ESDA. Module 2, Electrostatic Detection Apparatus. Module 3, Visual Spectral Comparator. Module 4, Conclusion. In addition to various types of microscopes like magnifying lens, compound microscope, stereo microscope and comparison microscope that are being used for the analysis of questioned documents, some instruments such as electrostatic detection apparatus and video spectral comparator are also used for the analysis of documents that are in question. These instruments are only meant for document analysis. ESDA is a forensic device used to decipher indented writings on paper. VSC combines sophisticated digital imaging and multi-wavelength LED technology with a clear and efficient software interface to provide a complete solution to the examination of all questioned documents. Electrostatic Detection Apparatus, ESDA. ESDA is an electrostatic detection device that is a specialized apparatus regularly used for question document analysis to decipher indentations or impressions in paper. It is a non-destructive technique. It is a sensitive technique capable of detecting indentations or impressions or subsurface writings created on pages which are several layers beneath the topmost sheet. It is also sensitive to the writings that were created many years back because of which indentations were made. It is a device used to visualize indented writing, which is a type of evidence which may be encountered during question document analysis in the cases of ransom note and extortion letters. Visual spectral comparator. VSC is the most advanced device used in the examination of questioned documents. It is an assembly of various light sources, filters and high resolution camera. It includes advanced features for the examination, comparison and authentication of documents. VSC is a comprehensive digital imaging system combining high resolution optics and multispectral illumination with a powerful software package that includes tools for image enhancement and decoding digitally encrypted data. Access to optical reference databases enables comparisons with authentic security documents. Now we will discuss both these devices, that is ESDA and VSC, one by one. ESDA technique is based on the theory that the paper sandwiched between grounded platen and mylar charging film acted as a capacitor with the change in capacitance due to differing compression of paper. This led to models like thickness variation theory and surface variation theory. Now we shall discuss about indented writings. Indented writing is a writing that is formed on a sheet of paper underneath the one on which the original writing was done. For example, if someone writes something on the top sheet of a notepad, the pressure exerted by the pen or pencil is sufficient to indent the papers beneath. Indented writings are the partially visible depressions on a sheet of paper that was underneath the one on which the visible writing was made while it was being written on. Such depressions are formed due to the application of pressure by the writing instrument during the process of writing. For example, the indented writing would appear as a carbon copy of the top sheet if carbon paper has been inserted between the pages. Indented writings have proved to be valuable evidence in some cases during investigation. For example, the top sheet of a bookmaker's records may have been removed and destroyed, but it is still possible to determine what was written on the sheet by the impressions left on the pad. These impressions may contain convicting evidences supporting the charge of illegal gambling activities, etc. When paper is studied under oblique or side lighting, its indented impressions are often visible and readable. ESDA takes advantage of the technology used in copying machines and laser printers to help visualize the indented writing. A sheet of thin plastic is placed over the paper that has the suspected indented writing, and both are placed in a vacuum chamber. A charge of static electricity is imparted to the plastic, and then toner powder is applied to the surface of the plastic. An image of this indented writing will be created on the plastic, with the added advantage that the original paper is not altered or damaged. ESDA methods can also be used to lift footprints in dust. Figure 1 represents electrostatic detection apparatus. Now we shall study the components of ESDA. First is the main unit. Second is reel holder, that is the imaging film. Third is the corona wand, and fourth is mains power adapter. Now we shall study the implementation of ESDA. It consists of the following steps. First, the document is humidified. Second, the document is placed on a porous electrically earthen platen so that it is drawn down by the action of a vacuum pump. A length of thin transparent imaging film is placed over the document to completely cover it. Third, negative electrical charge is deposited onto the upper surface of the imaging film using the handheld corona wand. Fourth, the operator waits for a short time while an electrostatic image forms on the imaging film. The nature of this electrostatic image is determined by the latent image of surface irregularities on the document. Fifth, the electrostatic image is developed and made visible by applying negatively charged black toner powder to the imaging film. The resulting ESDA image is therefore a life-size pattern of toner particles that are bonded to those regions of the imaging film where the electrostatic image presents an effective positive charge. Sixth, the ESDA image is made permanent by laminating the imaging film with a sheet of adhesive fixing film. Seventh, the laminated ESDA image is removed for the further examination, leaving the original document unaffected. Evaluation of material. First, sufficient material for examination. An electrostatic detection device works most excellent when a solo sheet of smooth paper that is without wrinkles, folds, creases or stains are used. Heavyweight, coated and treated papers give poor results. The age of the document is not a factor of concern in this examination. Invisible indentation has been dwelt on documents older than 50 years. Second, examination using oblique or side lighting. As a general rule, all the documents should be examined using side lighting. This is significant as they may detect deep indentations, which sometimes electrostatic detection device may fail to decipher properly. Third, documents that have been subjected to high levels of humidity will not generally retain indentations. As a result, other forensic examinations involving the wetting of a document, such as fingerprint development using a ninhydrin solution, should not be done until after examination for indentations. Instrumentation of ESDA. Preparation of apparatus. First is humidification. Electrostatic detection apparatus depends on the relative humidity of the environment. If the ambient relative humidity is less than 60%, then document humidification is required, and if the ambient relative humidity is greater than 60%, then document humidification is not required. Extreme humidification can destroy the document. Maintaining appropriate humidity is an important step to preserve the document and avoiding it from getting wet. Second is control sample. When the performance of the apparatus is required to be checked, the control sample is to be kept along with the questioned document sample for the comparison of results. It may be possible that the apparatus does not decipher the indentations, so in such case, result can be seen on control sample as well. If the indentations are present on control sample but not on questioned sample, it means questioned document does not have sufficient indentation to get deciphered. It also means that apparatus is working properly. Now the arrangement of platen. The questioned sample is placed on top of the flat platen surface and has some space on platen to allow the film to charge. First, the nature of document. Electrostatic detection apparatus works on solo sheet of legal sized paper. Mostly second sheet is taken to decipher indentation because it is a replica of original handwriting. I would also like to mention that the deep or heavy indented writing on a page should not be taken for examination because ESDA fails to decipher deep indentations. So that time we can take third or fourth sheet of document for examination because it will have normal indentations and can be deciphered by ESDA. Second is imaging film. Imaging film should cover document properly and touch the platen all around the document. Imaging film has two purposes. First, to develop electrostatic charge, and second, to develop any invisible indentation on the document. Also take care to avoid excessive stretching of the film. Third, charging of the surface. It is one of the processes in deciphering indentations. The handheld unit, that is a high corona wire, is used for electrostatic charge in this process. The corona van creates charge on the document and also changes charge to negative on paper. Since toner powder is negatively charged, after the charge has been developed on the surface or the paper, toner powder gets attracted to the paper and develops indentation by sticking to the paper. Fourth, toner to develop indentation. The electrostatic detection apparatus to visualize subsurface writings uses black toner powder. The variations in the charge of the surface and depending on the negative charged toner particles, they are attracted to the indentation writings on the paper. Once static charge has been applied to the film, the subsurface writing will be developed. Now the preservation of results. After the development of indentation writing, it is important to record the results. The result can be recorded using the following methods. First, adhesive lift method. The sheet or fixing paper is used to record the deciphered indentation. Fixing film is relatively a rigid sheet which is self-adhesive. The transparent polymer film is removed from backing material and cautiously fixing film is kept over the charged film. Pressure is applied carefully to fix the film by smaller roller, then create sandwich so as to easily lift. After the lifting, the examiner observes developed indentation before making visible markings on the developed indentation paper. Second is photography. After development of the indentation writing on document, then it should be preserved by using photography for legal purposes. Take the pictures of photographs with scale for the purpose of court. Third is scanning process. We can save our results using scanning process and preserve it for future perspective. we shall study the factors influencing the quality of final image by ESDA. First is document humidification and second is paper type. Paper has a very variable composition and differences in the basic raw materials. Chemical treatment, impregnation or surface finish will generally affect both the contrast and degree of background development in the image. We shall study the applications of ESDA in forensic science. The most important thing is question document examination. The various parameters studied are check forgery. In this category of forgery, possibility of checkbook in the hands of awful people can be there. The person can forge the signature on check and withdraw the money. In such a case, we can examine second check for any indentations present. Next is traced forgery. Traced forgery can be done by tracing signature or handwriting impressed on second page. The forger will follow the pattern of indentation of signature or handwriting to forge the signature or handwriting of someone. In this case, deciphering of traced forgery can be done using ESDA. Ransom note existence can be determined from the source of indentations by deciphering it on another piece of paper. It can be a culprit's notepad in case it is written. An anonymous letter may bear impressions of writings that relate to someone's everyday activity of the offender, which can ultimately lead an investigator to a particular suspect. It is designed to meet the requirements of immigration authorities, government agencies and forensic science laboratories. The VSC includes advanced features for the examination, comparison and authentication of documents including passports and travel documents, official letters and breeder documents, banknotes and checks, works of art and valuable artifacts through the detection of irregularities. Through the detection of irregularities, video spectral comparator comprises of the following: A. Laser induced breakdown spectrometer, B. Computer, C. Monitor. VSC is an integrated composite system comprising of cameras, various light sources which includes IR, laser, UV, etc. and filters which assist in comparison of questioned documents. Now we shall study the features of VSC. VSC is a comprehensive workstation and casework management system for document examiners and it has following features. First, hi-fi imaging technology, an optical system that minimizes spatial distortions and chromatic aberration throughout the entire magnification range, offering excellent image quality. Second, full range light source. It includes incident and transmitted ultraviolet to infrared plus high intensity illumination for the examination of infrared and fluorescence of inks. Third is graphic user interface. Innate on screen control system allows the operator to navigate the system more easily. Magnification, light sources, filters, image analysis and image processing functions are selected from the simple on-screen icons using mouse. Fourth is multiple laser images, that is MLI. MLI and changeable laser images can be viewed using the VSC's side lights. Alternatively, the VSC range of hologram imaging LEDs can be used, giving great flexibility. Fifth, latent images. A new software feature, a digital imaging filter that detects and enhances latent security images on documents. Sixth is the software. VSC ensures compatible combination of illumination and imaging filter automatically. Seventh, OVI imaging, an optical viewer that creates images of OVI print from two angles incident at 45 degree simultaneously. 8. Image comparison, a range of facilities for displaying images of two documents simultaneously including split screen, overlay, and alternate strobe. Ninth, microspectrometer. A high-resolution real-time grating spectrometer provides absorption, reflectance, transmittance and fluorescence spectra. Tenth, image integration. A variation in the IR fluorescence emitted by two inks provides a valuable means of detecting a fraudulent alteration to the document. 11th, data reader. The OCR allows operations to check data in the machine readable zone of passports and ID cards. It is used to detect and decode biometric passport data. 12th, areas of interest processing. By selecting restricted area of an image, the effects of image enhancement can be improved. 13th, barcode reader deciphers. 1D and 2D barcodes including PDF 417 format can be studied. 14. Image measurement. A software module that enables examiner to make a variety of measurement including distances, angles, areas, circle radii and shape perimeters. A simple calibration procedure also enables absolute values to be computed. 15th, birefringent security features. A circular polarizer will image security features printed with chiral birefringent pigment which appears to contrast against the background under the polarizer. 16, color measurement. Characterizes the color of a selected area of an image in standard color coordinates for comparison. 17, hyperspectral imaging, an advanced technique for the discrimination offense. A false color overlay highlights spectral differences. 18, additional features such as high resolution imaging system, image enhancement with pseudo color mapping, invisible information decoders, image processing and enhancement, and programmed examinations are important features present in VSC. VSC updated software is integrated with the document database system with single user license that enables the operator to generate their own database and to assess and display data from the KeySking reference database of security documents. KeySking is a reference database of security documents, that is passports, ID cards, driving licenses from 180 countries, comprising images and data. VSC is one of the latest system incorporating advanced technology and integrated system in the field of questioned documents. It is a highly versatile system. Visual spectral comparator is a comprehensive digital imaging system providing the questioned document examiner with an extensive range of facilities for detecting irregularities on altered and counterfeit documents. Now we shall study the specifications in VSC. First is digital imaging. High resolution scientific grade digital camera is there. Zoom magnification range of approximately 1.5 to 170 with plus minus 6% error on the standard 75 centimeter, that is 30 inches display monitor. Now key software features. It includes complete control of VSC's system hardware, image processing, comparison and analysis, hyperpectoral imaging module, seamless integration with document and banknote databases, and comprehensive casework management, automated examination routines, and interactive tutorial. We shall study the setup of VSC. The VSC consists of a main unit and a PC system. The main unit is one that can be seen in the picture with a square box with three flaps. In the main unit, one has a high resolution CCD firewire color camera with sensitivity 360 nanometers to 1100 nanometers. Different light sources and optical filters as well as a translight panel. The panel is situated in the center of the document platen. Underneath the panel are light sources which can illuminate the document from below. The main unit is as one that can be seen in picture, a square box with three flaps. In the main unit, one has a high resolution CCD firewire color camera with sensitivity from 360 nanometers to 1100 nanometers. Different light sources and optical fibers as well as a trans light panel. The panel is situated in the center of the document platen. In the VSC, there is also a high resolution grating spectrometer. This can analyze light from a small region in the document. As part of the VSC machinery is a 30 inches screen and a PC system which is Windows based. All this we are talking about is VSC 6000. The VSC main unit is seen on the left and the screen is seen on the right. Now we shall study about the light sources and their uses in VSC. The VSC has four different light sources. These are used to help bring out specific types of features in the document examined. The first light source is incandescent filament lamps. These have a range from 400 nanometers to 1000 nanometers and encompasses visible and IR light. These lights are used in the VSC when one uses the functions of flood, transmitted, spot and side lighting. The LED lamps, which have a wavelength from 400 to 700 nanometers, are used with coaxial lighting and diffracted lighting. The UV lamps are vapor discharge tubes. The VSC offers three ranges of UV light. This is with 365 nanometers UVA, 312 nanometers UVB and 254 nanometers, that is UVC, are the peak wavelengths. All of these can illuminate the document from above. With transmitted lighting, the VSC only offers UV light with 365 nanometers. The last of the light sources is a flash tube. This lamp has a range of 850 to 1100 nanometers and is used for the anti-Stokes flash function. The figure shows the inside of VSC main unit. The localization of the camera, two light sources, adjustable mirror and the trans light panel is marked. A function which uses narrow band illumination to excite fluorescence, this illumination is in the IR region from 800 nanometers and lack visible light. The VSC offers three different kinds of transmitted light. These light sources are located underneath the trans light panel. Here, transmitted UV light or transmitted broadband illumination illuminates either the entire panel or a single spot. Diffracted lighting is a function which illuminates the document from different directions and is usually used to see optically variable devices. The side lighting is also a broadband illumination. There are two lamps, one on the left hand side and one on the right hand side of the document platen. These can be used separately or both can be used at the same time. Coaxial light is another function the VSC offers. Coaxial light is light that is shown perpendicularly on the document. Coaxial light reveals retro-reflective features in security documents, which are often used to prevent forgeries. Such retro-reflective features are invisible under normal light but revealed when the incident light is precisely coaxial to the angle of view. The VSC also has a filter control panel. With this, the filters to be used in the camera and the spot lamp while using different functions can be chosen. This can determine if the whole range of incandescent lamps of 400 nanometers to 1000 nanometers will be measured. If only the visible light range will be let through the filter, or the operator can choose specific cutoff wavelengths. There is also a function where the VSC applies a sequence of camera filters in turn. This can be used, for instance, to see when a change like fading happens in the image. When using certain functions, the VSC recommends suitable camera filters to be used. Next is spectrum screen. The VSC offers microspectrometry with a resolution of up to 9 nanometers. The spectrum screen shows a chromatically charged and a spectral graph after a spectrum has been recorded. In the spectral graphs, one can read the plots of light intensity versus the wavelength from 400 to 1000 nanometers. At most, there can be 20 graphs at one time. There is also a list above the spectrum where one can input textual data of a specific graph and also decide on the color of the different graphs. Now we shall study the applications of VSC. It helps in revealing latent images and watermark. Latent images and watermarks are a commonly used security feature on banknotes worldwide. A latent image is visible only when viewed at an acute angle under reflected light, and watermark is viewed under transmitted light. Anti-Stokes illuminator. Examining UV activated security features, VSC is designed for the visual examination of question documents and security documents. Its applications are as under. First, used by immigration authorities and forensic laboratories. Second, effective on all types of passports and identity cards. Third, detects alterations and counterfeits. Fourth, reveals covert security features. Fifth, provides documentary evidence for prosecutions. Sixth, helps generate security alerts. Seventh, maintains comprehensive passport and banknote reference databases. Dear students, in this episode, we have learned about the instruments used in question document examination, such as electrostatic detection apparatus, that is ESDA, and visual spectral comparator, that is VSC. We studied the principle, instrumentation and working of ESDA along with its applications. ESDA is a technique used for decipherment of indented writing and also at times can be used for lifting of footprints from dust. Also, we discussed another instrument, that is VSC, visual spectral comparator. It is a comprehensive digital imaging system providing the question document examiner with an extensive range of facilities for detecting irregularities on altered and counterfeit documents. With all these information, here we come to the end of today's lecture. Do keep in mind what we discussed today. I'll be back with one more lecture in this series. If you want to know more or learn more and enhance your knowledge, you may log on to our website www.cec.nic.in for multiple choice questions, quizzes, LORs, etc. Thank you for your time today. I will see you the next lecture. Have a great day.